What is going on, guys? Mr. S here. Today we are going to do a drawing of Olaf. Start with your paper vertical. That means up and down, not side to side, horizontal. Vertical. We're going to start with two eyeballs. So his eyes are kind of round, with a second circle, and then a little bit of white in it. So, eyeball one. Eyeball two. Then he has what is almost like a half circle, but a little bit of a roundness at the bottom, at the nose. And then he has that typical Disney cartoon kind of wide mouth. So his mouth is actually going to be a slight curve line going from side to side. So a horizontal line with a curve that dips in the middle. And it is going to be wider than his eyes are. And then vertical lines with a little bit of curvature. And his smile dips down because he's a very happy kind of guy. One of the big things about Olaf is his buck tooth, and his buck tooth is going to be the same width as his nose. Okay, there we go. His eye, or his head, is going to have a dome. It's going to be kind of like a lowercase n, as I like to say with the younger kids, or kind of like the shape of an igloo if you're a little bit older. We are going to want it to be slightly wider than his smile is, so starting here and here. And it is going to stop up above his smile because he has those big, wide, fat cartoon cheeks. So it's going to go there. It's going to kind of even out and be flat at the top. And then it's going to dip back down. Boop. Perfect. All right. Then he has eyebrows. His eyebrows are going to be a little bit wider on the inside than they are on the outside. So it almost ends up being like a triangle. And they are wide on the inside. Then he has those cheeks. The cheeks are going to come out, and then they're going to come back down. There's going to be a little bit of flatness. So it's going to be out and down, out and down, and then a little bit of a flatness to that arc. It's not going to come down like a deep V like you would expect it to. Then he has a little bit of curvature out. A little bit of three-dimensionality there. And then he has what almost ends up looking like a skirt. So it comes down and out, and then down, and it meets. And his feet are almost rectangles, but they have a little bit of curve, so they're not extremely sharp. Everything here is kind of curved because he's kind of a round Disney character. And he has one button on this top section. And it's not quite a complete circle. We're thinking rough, like a piece of charcoal. And then there's a little highlight in each of those. So I like to draw the highlight circle first, and then go back and fill in. Obviously, you guys are going to fill in a little bit better than I am. I'm just kind of going quick to get you the example. And I like to have them standing on some snow. At the top of his head, he has three sticks. When we're doing the sticks, they don't need to be straight. It's best if they're kind of scraggly. Think about organic. So in nature, nothing is really perfect. That's what we're looking for there. His arms, we end up drawing them kind of like straws. They are very skinny, and they are parallel lines. Again, another stick. Can come out. You can think about a natural stick. You have a branch, and little twigs come off of that branch. A lot of times we draw him one stick up, one hand down. If possible, I like to make that end of his arm a little bit wider than the beginning of the hand, a little bit skinnier. Anyways, that is a quick, easy way to do Olaf. We can think about some extra things like some shadow around the top of his eyes, make it look like we're looking up at him, like they're a little bit sunken. But just a quick, easy drawing of Olaf to get your day started off right. Remember, you don't get it right the first time. We can try again. We can try again. We got to draw things a lot of times. If Mr. S has to draw it 3 or 4 times, then you guys definitely need to draw it a couple times to get it right. Hope you have a good time. Let me see what you draw. Can't wait to see next work. Bye.